Welcome back again. So we discussed one more problem. Problem number 3 of a transportation problem by using UV method. So that is the problem will be given in the examination that solve the following transportation problem, which means you have to obtain an optimum basic feasible solution by using UV method. But of course, I have considered the same problem 1, 2 and 3. The same transportation problem I have considered. In the first problem 1, I have calculated the initial solution by using VAM. We got the same cost at the end after applying UV method. We got 114 rupees. In the second problem as well, the same particular problem. In the second problem, I have calculated the initial solution by using Northwest Corner Rule. By using Northwest Corner Rule, the total cost is obtained as 128 rupees. Thereafter, again, by applying the UV method, we got 114 rupees, the same cost, minimum cost. Now we have to calculate. Now I calculate by using matrix minima method, initial solution by using matrix minima method. The initial basic feasible solution I calculate using matrix minima method. And so that again I calculate by using the, I apply UV method and I solve the transportation problem. And I obtain the optimum basic feasible solution of the transportation problem. And I check the transportation cost, whether it is minimum and whether it is the same, 114 or not. We should get the same, right? So for which you calculate, for this transportation problem, calculate initial basic feasible solution by using matrix minima method. So I take the solution directly, the initial solution, and then I concentrate on UV method. The solution of initial basic feasible solution by using matrix minima method, that is least cost entry method, which will be, I am writing here the solution, here we got 14, and in this cell we got 6, this is x21. It is 9, it is 1, and it is also 1. This is, in this particular cell we got 1, and in the last cell we got 4. Okay, this is what the initial basic feasible solution, 14, 6, 9, 1, 1 and 4. Whatever the solution you get, you take the solution and solve like this I explained. The UV method, how to apply UV method. I concentrate on UV method and show that this is the solution is obtained by using matrix minima method. Now I apply UV method. You see here 14, 9, 10, 16 and 1, 4 is 5. Similarly comes the column 6, 10, 15, it is 4. So I am erasing all these particular requirements and availabilities. Now I calculate by using UV method. You see here I consider what we have to go for next step in the UV method. In the UV method you have to consider, how many number of basic cells are there, whether they are m plus n minus 1 or not. After finding the initial solution by any of the methods, then we have to see, we have to examine whether how many number of basic cells are there. You count here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 number of basic cells are there. What is m plus n minus 1? M is 3, n is 4. 4 plus 3 minus 1, 7 minus 1. So m plus n minus 1 is equal to, n minus 1 is equal to 6. So there are exactly 6 number of basic cells are there in this particular transportation problem, that is by using matrix minima method. So now we can proceed. What we have to do next? We have to do next is you have to calculate, determine all ui and vj values by using basic cells. Through the basic cells, by using the formula ui plus vj is equal to ciz. Now you see here I explain by considering, by assigning one of the ui vj values to 0, sum of the ui vj values are 0, which means only one. Sum of either ui or vj, you consider one particular value arbitrarily assign as 0, and so that you calculate remaining all ui vj values by using the basic cells. By using the basic cells, for only the basic cells, by using the formula ui plus vj is equal to cij. So it is very simple calculation by simple addition subtraction. This is basic cell. So 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. Ui plus vj is equal to cij. Again, now this is basic cell because this value is available. So 1 plus how much is equal to? So 1 plus 1, it is 2. So therefore it is finished. Now come and take this value and come this particular and take this particular basic cell. This is 1. How much? 1 plus how much? It is 9. 8. 1 plus 8 is equal to 9. Finish. And thereafter, you can use also this. And this is the basic cell. 2, 1. So 1 plus how much is equal to 8? It is 7. 1 plus 7 is equal to 8. Next, now you consider this particular basic cell. This is 8. You can also consider this. Yeah. You can consider 1 plus 1. Yeah, you just calculated. Okay, fine. So if you consider this basic cell, 8 plus how much is equal to 5? 3. 8 plus how much is equal to 3? So answer is minus 5. 8 minus 5 is equal to 3. So therefore, one more value. Minus 5 plus how much is equal to 2? 7. 7 minus 5 is 2. So therefore, all ui vj values have been determined by simple addition and subtraction, by using the formula ui plus vj is equal to cij for all basic cells only, touching the basic cells, by considering the basic cells, calculating by using the basic cells only. By considering the basic cells only, you have to calculate this. So that is what you have to calculate, determine all ui vj values by assigning one particular value 0 or considering u1 is equal to 0. Arbitrarily you assign one particular value among all u1, u2, u3, v1, v2, v4. Any one value you consider as 0 and so that you can determine remaining all the values. So that is what the determination of ui vj values. After that, what you have to do? You have to calculate net evaluations by using the formula ui plus vj minus cij. I write the formula here. It is the formula ui plus vj minus cij. What is this? Zij minus cij. This is the formula for net evaluations. Calculate net evaluations for all non-basic cells. That is unoccupied cells. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Remaining 6 unoccupied cells are there. You calculate net evaluations by using the formula ui plus vj minus cij. Zij minus cij. Come and calculate. First one. 0 plus 7. 7. 7 minus 6. It is 1. Write in the within the parentheses in the right hand side top corner. Come over here. This is also non-basic cell. 0 plus 8. 8 minus 4. 8 minus 4 is 4. Write within parentheses, within brackets. 7 plus 0. 7 minus 5. It is 2. And this is another basic cell. 7 plus 1. 8. 8 minus 7. It is 1. And the another basic cell. 7 minus 5. 2. 2 minus 4, it is minus 2. Here it is 1 plus 5. 1 minus 5, not plus 5, minus 5. 1 minus 5, minus 4, minus 6, it's minus 10. So these are the calculations of net evaluations for all non-basic cells. Zij minus Cij. Now examine the sign of Zij minus Cij. Now examine the sign of Zij minus Cij. Some are positive. Some are positive. Here it is positive, negative, negative. So if all Zij minus Cij less than or equal to 0, then current solution is an optimum basic feasible solution. Here it is not the case like some of the values are positive. If some of the values are at least one Zij minus Cij is greater than 0, then we have to calculate maximum amongst them. That is, we have to calculate maximum of
zeta is a minus ci is a, for which zeta is a minus ci is a must be greater than 0. For all the values of I and j, we have to calculate this. So maximum of, now you see net evaluations, 1, 4, 2, 1, 1, 4, 2, 1. So what is the highest value? It is 4. Any value is more than, right? 1, 4, 2 and 1. The highest value is 4, which is obtained in the cell, this is 1 comma 2. It is at the cell 1 comma 2. Cell 1 comma 2, therefore cell 1 comma 2, 1 comma 2 enters the basis, enters the basis. This is a non-basic cell which is going to be entered into the basis, that is here. This is what the cell, it is going to be entered into the basis. What we are to do next? Which particular cell, non-basic cell enters into the basis, which was determined. So cell 1 2, the non-basic cell 1 2 enters into the basis. Therefore you have to calculate, you have to find a closed loop which starts and ends at the entering non-basic cell, that is 1 comma 2. You see the loop, after definitely you please remember, the loop will be existed one and only one, it is unique. Loop is unique, it is existed one and only one, no other loop can be find out for that particular cell. So therefore obviously no confusion. You see here, this is along with this particular cell, adjacent to that we have three cells. So therefore we can easily format the loop. Loop will be formatted connecting. Loop will be, should be start and at this particular entering non-basic cell and should connect all the basic cells, and you should come back to the again. And you should come back to the same entering non-basic cell, that is you should end at the entering non-basic cell. That is, this is what the, in this direction if you go here and if you turn over here and again if you come back, come to the another particular cell like here, and again if you go back and end at the cell entering non-basic cell, cell 1 comma 2. Here what we have to do, I combine two particular points. What you have to do? First of all, allocate plus and minus alternatively to all the cells of the loop with the entering non-basic cell, with the positive time, positive sign in the entering non-basic cell 1 comma 2. That is plus and minus etc. Here minus, here plus and here minus. And also allocate theta, plus theta, minus theta, plus theta, minus theta, like that. So these are the allocations. So therefore draw a big table. While having all the allocations are to be appeared clearly and visible. So right, therefore that is my intention to specify to you. Right. So now you have to calculate the value of theta. How to calculate the value of theta? The value of theta is going to be calculated by the formula. I am not writing the formula. Theta is equal to minimum of the quantities made in the cells which are having negative signs of the loop. Quantities made in the cells, the quantities are having in the cells having negative signs of the loop. What are the negative signs in the loop? Minus here, minus here. So in which you have to consider the quantities, here 14, here 9. That is 14 and 9. So therefore it is equivalent to be 9. So that is what the quantity here, 9. 9 is nothing but 9 is the quantity. It is going to be considered as the value of theta, which is obtained in the cell 2 comma 1, which is in the cell 2 comma 1. Therefore cell 2 comma 1 leaves the basis. That is what we have to determine. So now it was determined, two particular points were determined after calculating some calculations in the table. Cell 1 2 enters into the basis, that is non-basic cell, which is this cell 1 2, and cell 2 1 leaves from the basis. So now we have to go to the next transportation table. For example, you consider this is table 1. This is table 1. Now we consider this table 2. I have formulated already table. So you see here, this is table 2 if we consider. Now in the calculation, the next calculations,
you have to add theta, whichever is having the positive sign, we have to subtract theta, whichever having the negative sign, sir. Before that, I write the cos. Here 6, 4, 1, 5, 8, 9, 9, 2, 2, 7, and 4, 3, 6, 2, 4, 3, 6, 2. Okay. Now I do in the first calculation, at first I calculate in the second table, which part, what are the changes which are required? I add theta and subtract theta, starting with the entering non-basic cell by adding theta. So that is entering non-basic cell is this. Theta is the value is 9. So add theta here in the cell 1, 2, that is 9. And subtract theta, 14 minus 9. 14 minus 9, that is minus theta, having negative signs. That is minus theta. That is the reason why I have written plus theta, minus theta, plus theta, minus theta. So therefore, 14 minus 9, we have to add here, that is subtract here, that is 5. And come over here, come down. This is go through in this direction. So here 1 plus theta, 1 plus 9, 10. And 9 minus 9, it is 0. Now it is, I don't consider in the basis. So it is, it leaves from the basis. 9 minus 3, 9 minus 9, 0. So remaining cells, 6. Remaining cells, which are basic cells, remaining basic cells. 1, 4, and 4. Okay. Now I guess, now you see here, this is what the calculation in the next table first, in the next table. What we have to do first in the next table. So now again you have to continue the procedure. That is what we have specified clearly, step 3 to step 7. 7 or 8. Right? So therefore, what is step 3? Again you count how many number of basic cells are there, m plus n minus 1. Exactly m plus n minus 1 basic cells are there. You count here. 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exactly. Exactly m plus n minus 1 basic cells are there. Okay. I continue in that. This is, let you consider this is part 1. Let us consider this is part 1. I continue in the part 2. The next transportation table. The calculations of next transportation table, I continue in the next part.